So with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Abu Jahl, he had a lot of incidents where he came forth to harm Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And at that stage, remember, they still used to ask a few questions. They used to still talk to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and say, okay, tell your God this and tell your God that, and we want to know this and we want to know that. There were four main things that the kuffar of Quraysh had denied, or they were finding fault in. The first was the issue of wahdaniyah. Wahdaniyah meaning tawheed, the oneness of Allah. How can we worship one God when we've been worshipping so many gods all along? And this is why they began to call him mad. أَجَعَلَ الْآلِهَةَ إِلَٰهًا وَاحِدًا. Has he made all the gods into one God? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not make the gods into one God. No. He told them all these gods will neither help nor harm. You need to worship whoever made you. What was so wrong about that message? You need to worship whoever you are going to return to. The owner of heaven and hell, you worship him alone. The one whom you are answerable to, that is the only one you shall worship. That is Islam. And this is what Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam called them towards. We know the term Allah was used by them as well, because Allah means the worshipped one. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they did not deny that they were created by one supreme deity, but at the same time they refused to worship him alone. They only worshipped him when they were in serious trouble. So now Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam being faced with questions about tawheed. In fact, the oneness of Allah was something they continued raising. If you look at some of the questions that they had asked Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they told him, Sahirun kadhab, you are a magician and you are a liar. Where is he a liar from? What did he lie about? He is just telling them, look, this won't harm and it won't help. So it cannot harm or help itself. Why do you call me a liar? I'm giving you information. Go and try it, test it, see. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us all. They went on a smear campaign, character assassination, or what we can call a media campaign. On its own level at that particular time, they went around Quraysh saying, this man is possessed. It's confirmed that he's a madman. The doctors have come in, or the experts have come in. They've confirmed this man is possessed. He's a madman. Or they continue to say he is a fortune teller. You see, he's coming to say things of the future. And then they also said he's a very, very eloquent poet. But what he came with was not poetry. They also said he's mad, possessed, and he has within him a jinn. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us. They then said someone has done magic on him. And at one stage they even said he's a magician himself. Because the magicians, they separate between husband and wife. And all these accusations amounted to nothing when it came to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Inna kafaynaka al-mustahzi'een. We have protected you against those who mock about you. So they can mock, it will be to their detriment, not to yours. Up to today, that verse is valid. Those who want to mock at Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they want to draw cartoons about him. They want to make images and they want to try and make fools of what the messenger's message was and so on. Allah says, don't worry. We have protected you from that. You are far higher than all they can do when it comes to mocking. And it will be against them. Did you realize that when the cartoons were drawn lately, it resulted in great exposure for Islam and the Muslims, and so many people turned to Islam. For the first time in their lives, they found out that it is a religion of purity, the purest of all religions, and they began to turn. Had it not been for those cartoons, they probably would have still been lying in their ignorance. So, as we say, رُبَّ ضَارَّةٍ نَافِعَةٍ. Sometimes something appears negative, but there is a lot of positivity that comes out of that negative.